Welcome to Shenanigans, everybody. How are you guys all doing today?
Very good.
Oh, Neil, did you do the tweet?
Yes, I did. I did do the tweet.
Ooh, did you?
I did. I didn't list anyone in it because there's like five of you and. She has been such a prima donna all morning.
How are people going to know to go to my stream if you don't tweet about it, Neil?
Yeah.
What's your stream, Rob? Tell us about your stream.
He
was not ready for this one.
Damn you, calling me.
So I think everyone you'll notice over there is Greg. He's going to be our guest dungeon master for today. Greg, what's going on?
Not a lot. It's been a good morning, man. I got up early and I deadlifted and ate some nice breakfast. I'm sorry?
How much did you deadlift?
I deadlifted 285.
Wow. That's a lot.
That's
right?
Not that much. If anyone knows anything about deadlifting, that's not a lot of weight.
Okay.
But it's good for me because I have tight hamstrings from back when I used to run and play basketball all the time and never stretched and then got a job where I sit down all the time. Mm-hmm. So deadlifting is important to like keep me from, you know, snapping like a rubber band.
Mm-hmm. That doesn't sound very pleasant.
No. But it's good to do. It's fun. I prepped up last night. I'm excited. I didn't realize we're going to have so many people, which is great. I'm thrilled.
Fantastic. Chloe, long time no see.
Hello, yes, I've been busy moving to Scotland, like the mad bastard I am, because, you know, Scotland, why not, right? Hi. I actually thought I should try getting fit and decided to do some pull-ups this morning, and I couldn't do any. I was just there going like, what? I could do like 10, which is quite good for me. And then I stopped doing them for a while. And now I'm just there going like, no, not happening. So I did a few press ups instead and decided that I really need to start working out again because that's just shameful. Hi, I'm really unfit.
Wow, fantastic. Simon, what's up with you, man?
No, it's good, man. I've had 2 weeks off from work, so I've been relaxing, just trying to fix stuff here at home.
Cool.
And, you know, playing games at the usual. Yeah.
Anything in particular you're playing?
Witcher 3 now.
Very nice.
Yeah, it's a really good game.
I'm interested in your opinion of Witcher 3, because I played it, and I couldn't make up my mind whether or not it was the best game I had the least fun playing, or the worst game I had the most fun playing.
I thought Witcher 3 was fucking amazing. I really like it.
It's very intricate, like with the quests. Like there's never really a simple quest, in my opinion. Like there's like, oh, go do that, go fetch that. However, it's wrapped very nicely, like in a little ribbon. Like so, it's like you get a lot of eye candy when you do it. But a lot of it is glorified fetching, killing quest, I guess. But
it is
still
fetch me 10 bear asses.
Yeah, but they make a pretty good, you know, attempt of like, you know,
the combat's fun as well. So
yeah, and combat is good. The story is pretty fantastic, but yeah, the quests are very much fetch and kill quests, but wrapped very nicely.
Or detective quests, which is quite interesting. Or
detective Witcher.
Yeah, although I will say that the world is amazingly well done, and the combat's fun. And, you know,
it's so gorgeous. So yeah, that's what I've been up to.
Cool.
Nice.
What about you, Nick? You look like you're about to kill someone. Is there a particular reason for your wrath today?
It's just been a long night. I went to Wigan for a party last night. I don't know if you're not going to know where Wigan is, but it's kind of...
I know where Wigan is. I'm sorry, man. I'm sorry.
Yeah, it's just a bit shit. So went to Wigan last night for this party and then drove back at like 2 a.m. and then stayed at my girlfriend's parents and then came back here. And I've just been, you know, I was telling you about all the shit I had to read. I've just been reading that. Look, here's the folder I've got. Read this over the weekend.
What is it?
It's like, I work in finance. It's all like market forecast stuff to do with Brexit.
Yeah, because the stock market just went,
Yeah, exactly. Yes. I've got a big meeting tomorrow, so I've got to read a lot for tomorrow. So it's just been a pretty shit, stressful day. But, you know, take some time off now.
You poor fucker.
Two of the people here are no longer European.
No, we're still European.
Yeah, still European.
There is a non-zero chance the government's going to be like, actually, we're doing another redo, do over, and you know they're going to try and find some way to wangle it so we don't actually.
Yeah, there's a few things about that in the news at the moment. I think there's going to have to be another election, and because most of the MPs are pro-Remain, so even if they have a Leave Prime Minister after Cameron leaves, the MPs still have to vote to agree to sign the Article 50 treaty to leave the EU. So if the MPs vote it down, then there'll have to be another election to put in like pro-Leave MPs. But then maybe the Labour Party will get in and they'll say they won't leave or something like that. So maybe there's a chance.
I think that's wishful thinking. I think you guys are screwed. You're out of Europe. So hey, I would like to take this off.
I'm in Scotland. Scotland vote to remain. Scotland, there's a non-zero chance that Scotland's just going to be like, too late, your lord.
I would just like to take this opportunity to offer you a chance to join a winning team. You can be the 51st state. You get a star on our flag.
Well, they should get 51 through 54, England, Scotland, Wales, Northern Ireland.
True.
And we count them as separate states. England, we're looking at you.
I'm pretty sure that's never going to happen.
It'll give you the chance to vote against Trump.
Why would we leave the EU only to join the United States?
I can't even list all the reasons why. They're miles long.
Okay. No,
would
I mean,
you
I'm
rather quite, watch French cinema or American cinema?
Doesn't work like that, does it? I don't know. We're not fucked. It's not that bad if we leave. Obviously, it's not great, but things will be okay.
Yeah, it'll be fine.
Yep.
Well, I think that's everybody. Rob, you didn't have anything to say about your stream, but did you have something else to say?
No, I was here to... I did want to talk about characters here. So I know people in the past have claimed that my characters are broken. So I just want to say, today, I am playing a freaking kobold. About as unbroken as you could possibly be.
How are you going to do the voice, though?
I decided I was going to do a kobold before I'd like fully investigated just how fucked they are in skills and powers. This is my theory. If you go through every other race, it's a very nuanced balance. So they go, somebody really wanted to play this. And then they got to kobolds and they were just like, yeah, fuck kobolds. And I kind of feel like whoever wrote the description there, like her dad must have run off with a kobold and chopped up. Because they're like, okay, we need to balance the minus stats with stat bonuses. And they're like, well, here's some minus stats. They don't need stat bonuses. And every other race is like, you know, they've got this mix. Well, like, okay, like, you know, Charger, he wasn't able to sit down, you know, for the cockpit. He could, like, dual wield lances. And they were just like, well, we're going to let kobolds see in the dark, I guess. The monster manual says they do, but...
they get attacked last in combat.
Yeah, so their only positive ability is they're so shitty. Even the description of them as a race is like, they're so shitty, no one does. I put out my stats, and then I found out two of them were too high to be kobolds. And they rearranged my stats. Because they were like, kobolds must be shitty. A kobold with 15 charisma, that would be OP. Again, let's let the centaur with all the strength and extra hit points, dual wield lances, but 15. would be OP for kobolds. But everybody who's all, his character is always broken and OP, playing a kobold.
All right, so hey, how'd you break them?
I've played a kobold before. They are fun.
Not here on Shenanigans, though.
No. It was Distracted Elves. It was like a homebrew sort of steampunk type sort of D&D thing, but you know, most of the rules were fairly standard. It was just reskinned.
Yeah.
Pocket? Yeah. No, what do you call it? No. What do you call it?
Tap it.
Tap it.
Hi, hi, hi. Oh, hi. How are
Alright.
So I'm pretty sure the working title of the Dungeons & Dragons Skills and Powers book was Dungeons & Dragons Skills and Fuck Kobolds. That's all I can say.
And the fine print.
I really want that to be true. Like, I'm imagining this, like, dark room that's candlelit. It's got Gary Gygax and all his other cult followers. And he's like, guys, I just want to say, fuck Kobolds. We're going to make a book to tell everyone how awful Kobolds are. And all of us are like, all hail Gygax. All hail Gygax.
Fuck Kobolds. Fuck them all.
All right, so let's go ahead and jump into it, I guess. Okay. We're all going to be starting in Shenanigans because it's Shenanigans. It's the name of the show. We got to start there. And it seems like we have some new characters to introduce to the friends and family viewing us on stream and also each other. So why don't we start with what you guys are doing in the bar and just kind of introducing new characters as they come in.
My name is Artie. I am a 2'9", 36-pound gnome. I am bald with big kind of brownish splotches all over my head. I've got muddy brown eyes and very small hands, like unusually small, even for my size.
Like Vienna sausages?
Trump, you always want to make a Trump joke as well. It's just like,
hello.
Excellent, Artie.
I am a cleric. A cleric of Ephra, who is the goddess of kind of art and inspiration. But I'm a very bad cleric. I have a problem with alcohol, and I'm not always all that loyal to my goddess. And I tend to kind of shit on some of the things she says or wants to do. And I have a 20% chance of failing my spells as a result. Or if you want to talk mechanics, I only have 9 wisdom. So I'm kind of just a really terrible cleric, and I'm a gnome, but I'm kind of a drunken gnome, so he doesn't always follow the proper
Got some gestural influences in there.
Yeah, it's just... He's a bit of a mess, and he's 93 years old.
Okay, excellent. Rob, why don't you tell us about your kobold that has walked into Shenanigans?
The Arb is just a little kobold, in a big, big world, trying not to get stepped on, trying not to get kicked again, probably fail. Just a kobold. He has okay. He has a stick, which he planned out how to make it himself.
Very good. He learned how to make a stick.
Mm-hmm.
Excellent. Alrighty, I don't think we need to introduce ourselves to Alejandro. Luther, why don't you introduce yourself?
Alright, I don't know if anyone's seen Luther, but that's the inspiration for this character. He's 6'3", broad-shouldered, black skin, short black hair, beard, wearing hide armor and a long gray cloak, sort of like pulled over, a red sort of silk scarf under his armor, sword and shield, daggers, typical fighter. Gruff voice, you know, good-natured but grumpy and doesn't follow the rules but gets results and makes his gold looking for bounties and killing people who need to be killed and arresting people who need to be arrested.
All right, excellent. And I believe our last party member is Fuzzy. Who are you bringing to Shenanigans?
You're muted, Fuzzy.
You're muted, Fuzzy.
Fuzzy here?
Derp, 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 herp, derp. Yeah, I'm playing Dave Growl, the bard. He's probably already in Shenanigans. He's just sort of like noodling in a corner on his butt, on his loot and just, you know, just being really out of it as usual.
Alrighty. So I guess you're noodling in the corner with your loot. Alejandro, you have made the acquaintance with these strange fellows that have walked into your bar. And it's a fairly normal day in Shenanigans. But what catches your eye is there's a newcomer to town. Clearly he has rode hard through the wilderness to get here. His clothes are ragged and torn a little bit. Stinks of peasantry. And he's arguing in the corner with Desmond. And you can all overhear this argument as he raises his shrill voice and is screaming about his father, or not his father, his brother, who is changed and different, and he needs an adventure. He needs someone like Desmond to come and investigate this strange brother of his. And Desmond's waving him away with his hand, saying, "Ah, no, I'm retired now. I'm not going to go investigate your brother." He waves his hand out in the bar. Find someone out here. There's fine folks that can help you, I'm sure. And what are you all doing in the bar?
Right now I hear the shouting, like, when they're shouting, VR gets kicked.
I'm just what? Taking my free complimentary drink from Shenanigans.
Yes. What is your drink of choice, Alejandro?
I'm trying to get into Virgenbitter just because I'm drinking it in remembrance to Rune.
Oh.
I've heard him, you know, he's
pouring a little out.
Yeah, indeed.
Okay.
Greg, go on.
Go for it.
I'm like standing by the bar, sort of loudly complaining to Desmond about just the shit things in my life. And perhaps when this guy comes and starts speaking to him, I sort of shut up and start listening to what he's saying and think about maybe interjecting and offering my services.
Sure. Do you interject?
I'm gonna give it a minute or two, see what he does when Desmond turns him away.
Okay. So I guess as you guys sit and just listen and tell, he gets more animated, and eventually his eyes kind of go distant. You can tell this, Luther, but probably the rest of you, a little hard to tell sitting at your table. And he begins talking in kind of a lower voice to a lower voice than the shrill high pitch, but still loud enough that it carries the tavern. And he says, "Look, Desmond, you don't understand. My brother, he has a cottage with a hawthorn tree and a lilac bush, a plump young wife with starry eyes. My brother's a fine coat, vest, the color of moss. People trust him. And this man, he has all these things and his face. But you don't understand, Desmond, he can't be my brother. Just last week, I killed my brother."
Oh, shit.
And he just stared.
Has well-written flavor text.
Dude. What the fuck are you smoking, man?
He turns around and looks at you.
Yo, have you got? Can I get some? Have you got?
He says, I haven't smoked a thing in my life. I swear it."
"So what are you saying? You want someone to kill him again?"
"I tried to smoke a sausage, but it just burned up."
"You are a very strange fellow. But no, I don't know. I don't know what he is. He doesn't look at me. He's different than he was, but he's the same, and he's earned everyone's trust in town because he always does. It's the way my brother is. I need people to investigate him."
"Times change. The same? Stock rates fluctuate."
"I'm sorry, what were you saying there, Luther?"
"Does he act the same? Is he the same man that you killed?"
Yes. He acts as same as he ever was. The only thing is he won't look me in the eyes."
"Well, I'm not surprised. You did murder him.
Why did you kill your brother?
Checked he's actually not like some sort of really, you know, together zombie? A lich? A necromancer? Something like that?"
I don't know. I'm a farmer. I don't know these things."
"Also, why are you admitting to murder, man? That shit's not cool. Not at all, man.
Totally, I love your brother. Why'd you kill him?
Yeah, man. That's totally uncool, bro.
Perhaps he's your brother from another mother.
So, stepbrother?
I only had one mother, and only the one brother. Why I killed him. Perhaps I need to tell you the whole story. Come, sit with me, all of you. Perhaps if you hear my story, you'll know the
need. Right, don't go crazy and murder anybody, dude, okay?"
I lean to the closest person. Perhaps his mother had another
life. It'll probably be me.
All right, he sits at the table with the four of you, and he kind of leans back, his eyes kind of go distant. He's clearly remembering, right? There's this kind of distance to his stare, not at any of you.
Strange man's having a flashback.
Yeah. And with your fingers waving in the air, he begins to recite from his memory. And he says, "For a month, our village was plagued by an unknown beast. It wrecked fences and killed livestock. My brother lost 3 sheep in 1 night, but I was safe. I own no animals. The town hall, when I offered to hunt the beast, everyone laughed at me until my brother said, "We'll hunt it together." We went out that night. The woods were cold, quiet, dark. We passed a tree with leaves like a lady's hands reaching for me. My brother pushed them aside with his walking stick. "A common oak," he says. We passed a stream that sounded of hypnotic singing. He grabs me by the shoulder. A common babbling brook. And he leads me past. We found a hole, deep and full of black. It smelled of lilac, but we found the beast, eyes of gold, snarling teeth glinting off the torchlight, and I hid. When I returned from my hiding place and found my brother, he had slain the beast. "Just a great wolf," he says. "'Twas only ever a wolf." And we laughed and chuckled and cried and laughed at how I had hid and how grateful the villagers would be. And his eyes narrow to him. I took my club and I hit him in the face again and again until he stopped moving. And I dropped my brother down the deep black hole. I told the villagers, "We've been separated. The beast must have devoured him. This is the only trace I found, but I killed the beast. I avenged my brother, and I showed them a torn piece of his fine cloak." The villagers congratulated me even as they consoled me. But 3 days later, my brother, he came from the woods. "I can't believe I got so lost," he said. "Me, who lived by these woods my whole life. Thank the gods for my brother. Thank the gods he killed that devil. But I was the only one that noticed. His fine cloak, it wasn't torn. And now each night I'm tormented by nightmares. My brother's limp and lifeless limbs, his face all red, and something digging a grave." And he trails off and stares vacantly at the five of you.
Well, our flavored text is as tragic as it is well written. And very disturbing.
That's one hell of a story for a peasant.
That story is very familiar. Anyway,
My brother used to hit me with a stick.
Oh, dude, that's uncool.
I'm very, very sorry for you and your familial ties, little lizard. I fear my brother may be much worse now.
Maybe you shouldn't have murdered him in the first place, because it you know, maybe some spirit of vengeance come back
like
to get
someone
you.
Got his yes desserts. Is there dessert, by the way?
Wait, who got his just desserts? Murder face here, or the brother?
Tormented, you know, karma.
I don't know what he is or anything about this. I just know it can't be my brother. There's something wrong. I need someone to find out what's going on. I'm deeply disturbed.
Were you drunk as a skunk when you gave him big thunk?
When I gave him big thunk, what? I'm sorry.
Were you drunk as a skunk when you gave him a thunk? Drunk as a skunk.
No, I wasn't drinking. Neither was he. He just.
Have you gone back to check the body?
Hit him and hit him. He couldn't have been alive.
So you were jealous of your brother, as well, though.
Do you murder him a lot?
I don't plan to be.
Have you murdered anybody else? I mean, is this the first time? You know, because you sound like you're liable to snap at any moment. To be honest with you, dude.
No. I've never done anything like this in my life. It just.
I think you should go and turn yourself into the local law enforcement.
No.
No local
law enforcement. Did you go back and check the hole?
No, I was too scared to go back in the woods.
Did you consider that maybe you're dead and this is the punishment that's been conferred upon you to always see your brother as alive?
Perhaps. I will admit I've done a wicked thing, but it seems unlikely that the gods would punish me by bringing back a soul gone by. I have never heard of this in any stories from the churches.
I don't know. Gods do all kinds of bad things. Sometimes I think gods think, fuck kobolds.
It's true.
I have heard
that
the Lord Gygax is very angry with kobolds.
It is known.
Well, whatever this is, it sounds like some sort of demon. Or undead, or some other creature that befouls the village that you live in. I'd be happy to travel there and at least investigate. I'm not scared of the woods. And check his corpse.
Dude, I like a nice walk in the woods, man. Yeah.
I'm scared of the woods. I'm scared of everything, so it doesn't matter where I am.
Last time I went for a walk in the woods, though, man, I don't know, man. I think I got lost or something. For like weeks.
One time Alejandro had to tackle this man who could change shape. He had disguised himself as Bixby. Like, I get a little down, like, is Bixby's also dead?
Poor little man.
I pull one out for Bixby too, as I say this. Perhaps.
Surprisingly, Desmond doesn't seem to mind you pouring it out. He seems to have also poured out some.
Yeah. Probably into another mug, though, under the counter.
So maybe this is a shapeshifter of some sort?
A shapeshifter? Does that mean it could be his sister? Posing as his brother? Or maybe another lover?
From another mother?
Quite possible.
Wait. Whose mother's
Why
lover?
Why do I even bother?
His mother's lover could be his sister.
That's
he's his own grandpa.
It would explain something. Like that amount of inbreeding, dude. That amount of inbreeding would explain a bit of, you know? You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. I think I have a song about this. Artie runs outside and starts to haul back inside this really old, beaten up, and kind of dented tuba.
Dude, that is cool.
You guys can continue.
Please, are you singing for us, Neil?
Well, you can't sing and tuba at the same time.
You said you had a song.
Well, he's got a musical song to play. He's not going to sing for you, but he'll he'll tuba poorly.
Yeah, Dave's gonna swing the lute round and just start like improv riffing on this, because you know.
I take it back. He doesn't.
No.
Tuba poorly.
You tuba very well. Yeah. It is a great. It sounds like that, only much better to the ears. And everyone.
It does not sound like a dead elephant. Like a tiger elephant.
Excellent. The man kind of looks at you, Artie, and says, there was a very beautiful tubaing, but I don't know how it helps. What was it about the tuba that comes to my situation? Like, how does it apply? I don't understand.
I'm not sure it does.
A metaphor. You see this, there's the wide bell of the tuba. The bell symbolizes how all the larger things have been pulled together. Your life by this one event has been pulled together into this single point of misery and destruction by that singular action, as simple as the puff of a breath. Maybe.
It's meant to give you inspiration, which can apply to any situation.
I don't really understand, oh. But if you are all willing to help me, I will look past your quite frankly strangeness.
You're the one who murdered your own brother, dude.
No, he's right. Niarb is strange.
Kinslayer!
You're a kobold. Strange is like par for the course, man. You're a tiny inept lizard.
Say we go and do this. What's in it for us?
He gets a downtrodden look on his face. He says, you must understand, I'm but a poor farmer. My life savings are 50 silver coins. I could give them to you. He thinks for a second, says, oh, I know that's not much. I feared that
Did you loot your brother after you killed him? You should always loot the body.
I wasn't thinking like that. I was a little overwhelmed with emotion at the time.
You had just lost a brother.
You're awesome.
And the murderer was close by.
He nods.
The closest.
He says,
There's no need for your coins. I'm sure if this is some sort of demon and we kill it, the town will reward us.
Perhaps, yes. We are a poor farming town. But I thank you for your kindness and generosity, Mr. Luther. But for you, good sir, with the peg leg, if need be, I do have my mother's ring. She has died and passed it on to me. And he shows it to you. And it's a simple gold banded ring, but it has this gemstone cut in the center. It's got this kind of smoky rose color around the outsides. And there's this bright white kind of star shape in the center. And he says, I don't know what this is worth, but my father, when he was alive, won it from a gnome, a traveling gnome, in a contest of wits.
So you remember
to that's mine. I recognize that from my home. My mother was a gnome. That's her ring. Come now, or I'll sing to the police.
He says, I assure you, my father won it fair and square, but should you help me?
Hush now, I want to hear him rhyme something with police.
Fleece?
Shut up! You're just a stupid kobold.
That's true.
You're never gonna grow old.
That's true.
You're not being a kobold, dude. I'm cool.
At least you can't look down at each other.
How tall are you?
I don't know, kobold height. I'll actually like get down on my knees. Like, you can look down on me now.
I say, come here, and come the arp. Like I put you on my shoulder. There you go.
Aww,
oh, dude. So tall.
This is what it must be like to matter.
I look up like, you do matter. It's like
only if you go splatter.
Oh, shots fired. Okay. At this, the man kind of looks to you. He says, will this do? My coins in the ring? Will you come and see to my strange brother's affliction or whatever it may be?
I do not care for the ring or the coin, but I think that the others might. So yeah, I'll come at least. But
yeah, man, it might make a good like song or story or something. That might be cool.
Okay. Undead affliction or brother killing addiction, it makes no matter. Let's go.
But Alejandro is oldest in the, well, in the adventuring business, so Alejandro will lead. Party hats for everyone.
Oh my god, you have more? Oh my god.
Did you just hold those things or what?
Everyone get a party hat.
Yay!
Oh, very nice. So with party hats equipped, I guess, he will lead you the way. He tells you that his village is a small one, unnamed on most maps, that lies a 1.5 days ride southeast of Shenanigans into the forest. And he mounts up a rather haggard looking horse that is clearly a very poor quality and has been ridden hard. And begins to lead the way. Do you guys all have mounts as well, or are we hoofing it real hard?
Artie has a donkey.
I
have no mounts.
So, because Alejandro has my, they never really spend it on anything.
Do you guys want to do any provisioning or anything else in Bergshire here before we head off?
I would like to find out how far away it is.
He says it's a days and a half ride. He doesn't do so well with miles, but he guesstimates it's about 36.
All right. Will there be food where we're going?
He says, yes, the village often has common meals for everyone. The wives get together and cook for us.
Okay. Artie will go buy... I'll be
numb for a little bit there.
Artie will buy a loaf of bread before he takes off then, but not much else.
Sure.
I guess Artie was speaking common there instead of gnomish.
Perhaps he was. Perhaps he was. Just find your bread price in the sure. player's handbook. No different.
Artie is a bad gnome. He doesn't rhyme. He's drunk all the time. He's a bad cleric and a terrible gnome. An outcast of his society.
Okay, I'll go up to who's minding or who's taking the food orders and everything here.
Who's taking food orders? You can get food here at Shenanigans. I'm sure that Borscht Thunderbowls will part with some, you know, nice food stuffs for you. There's also a general store you can go to in your car.
Borscht, I would like to buy some gruel and bread crusts.
Mmm. Fitting food for a meager individual. And he goes and finds, like, the oldest bread he has and cuts off the, like, crust of it exactly. Doesn't give you any of the nice white portion of it. And spoons you out a bowl of, like, yesterday's gruel. Says, 5 copper for the little kobold.
Mm-hmm. So I give him 5 copper for my bread crust and gruel and all.
Excellent.
I guess I'll carry this bowl.
Excellent.
Well, I'll drink the gruel and put the bread crust in my little backpack.
Okay. You have a gruel backpack? How does that work?
No, I'm going to drink the gruel and I'll put the bread crust in the backpack.
I switched that. Okay, cool. So it doesn't sound like anything else going on. We're going to head off into the woods.
Yep.
Our as of yet unnamed man leads the way. And let me check and see what we have going on for encounters here.
Maybe we should actually ask him his name. What is his name?
He tells you that his name is Gregor. And if you ask for his brother's name, it is...
Sandor.
Huh?
Oh, no, sorry. No, nothing.
It is, his brother's name is Nicholas. Nicholas and Gregor.
Nicholas and Gregor.
Did his brother come back from the dead with a mysterious mustache?
He says, no, the face is the same as it was when I can get a look at it.
Hmm.
His handsome face.
And he refuses to look at you?
Yes, I can't. He won't ever turn his gaze fully on mine.
Aside from that, he is the same as always?
Indeed.
Has he been talking with the other villagers at all? Interacted?
Yes, very much so, as he always did. He's very popular. Everyone likes him and trusts him. We have a small watering hole, and they all drink there. He's quite a popular person, really.
Does his wife seem happier than normal?
He turns back to you as he's riding and says, I didn't think anyone could be happier than my brother.
No, does his wife seem happier than normal?
Does his wife? Yeah, man. Does his wife notice anything out of the ordinary? She knows him best, surely. So
I don't speak to her often.
But does she look weirded out? Right, so she's not walking around going, or anything like that, you know?
No, nothing like
or
that.
Or does she look like he brought some new ideas to freshen things up?
I don't catch your drift. You drift, little one.
Why don't we go to the hole and check his corpse? And
yeah, man. Good
what we find there, let's go and find him and force him to look at you. Maybe that will reveal some indications.
So your first day of travel is slow, but goes by peacefully. The woods are just normal woods. You hear the sound of wildlife, and you clomp along on your few horses, and you also, you know, walk along beside them. And day comes and goes. The second day. Aha.
The one, the indicator that something is going on.
I do want to mention Artie is riding a donkey whose name is Orange.
What is a 7? Okay.
Is it because you can't rhyme with it? Or what?
Very nice. I like Orange the donkey. As you guys are traveling along after the second day, he assures you you're probably 6 hours outside of his village. You travel for a good hour or two that day, and you come across a bear-like creature about the size of a large dog. It is brown fur like a bear and thick like one up front, but has a snout and features a lot like a weasel. And you clearly surprise it as it has it had it head down and was hunting as you come across it. Its ears back and it squeaks and barks at you. What do you all do?
Is it sunny out?
Yes, it is. It is sunny out, but it is dark inside the forest, right? Sun flits through the leaves, but it's dim in here.
Hey, little bear dog, dude. Hey, hi.
Should we go around it? Or should we take a mallet and pound it?
Does it look like it's going to attack?
What kind of creature is it?
Huh?
What kind of creature is it?
Do you have some kind of knowledge of the forest or other nature that you could roll?
Just a simple kobold. With obscure knowledge.
I have animal lore. I have 13 in animal lore.
Roll me some animal lore.
Right. So that's 1d20. Right, I forgot completely what I had to roll. 1d20 plus
wisdom, I believe, is the check.
Wisdom.
Okay. Animal lore I don't think has a modifier.
Right, okay. Wisdom.
If you've got 13 written down, that'll be what you add.
Right, okay, yeah. So yeah.
Alrighty. Dave Growl, you correctly identify this species of creature as a wolverine.
Oh, it's a wolverine. Dude, watch out. They're like assholes.
They're super mean.
Ooh, it's by itself. It's much better when it's with others. But it's so lonely.
Yeah. Let's just go around it.
Yeah, let's go around it, dude.
Let's go around you, yeah.
Chill, little wolverine dude. We don't want you, man. We're looking for bodies.
All right, so dude. I want the group to make a like combined animal handling check to move around it in a way that doesn't startle this already surprised and aggressive creature. So everyone roll like animal handling. If you don't have that as a proficiency or secondary skill, go ahead and take a -5 to your wisdom. And we're gonna see an average group here.
Is it just wisdom, you know, flat wisdom, Greg?
Yes, sir. -5 if you don't have animal handling of some variety.
Is it willpower, though? Like,
yeah,
I'm guessing.
It's funny, yeah. It's willpower, yeah.
Willpower, yeah.
Wisdom, willpower, yeah, yeah.
Oh, I am 6 willpower. Great.
So shy of that success, I think.
Alrighty. So, despite the best efforts of...
I got a 37!
Despite the best efforts of your kobold, he is very good at becoming small and meek and unthreatening. The rest of you just burrow past this small, angry creature, and it decides to lash out at you. I think it's time for initiative, gentlemen.
I'm ready for this. I'm totally ready for this. I gotta look at this.
Individual initiative, Greg, or not?
Yes, please.
All right.
I think this counts for the old 1-2. Is it plus 2?
It's your weapon speed, right? I'm getting my bow out, so...
This is totally
rocks. Alejandro, 11. Artie, 11. Ooh. Dave Growl, 10.
You said we're south of Berkshire, like 30 miles?
Southeast. You're traveling like due southeast.
Okay. So we're going near the swamp wash, is what you're telling me.
Yep, you're going that direction.
Okay.
But you're not all the way there.
No, but we're more than a day there, right?
Yeah, yeah.
So we're a little past 25 miles.
Luther, did you roll?
Yeah, I got an 11.
Oh, okay, there we go. We have 3 11s. Okay, well, Bar, you go first. Mr. Kobold.
Oh, I actually get to go first?
You do.
Oh, perfect. I'll step in front of everybody else. and I'll say, it's okay. If you really want to attack someone, you can attack me, Mr. Wolverine. And I'll cast, Calm Animal.
Ooh, interesting.
No save.
No save.
Unless it's a magical Wolverine.
No, this is a normal old Wolverine. Okay, tell me, read the spell to me. I haven't had a player use Calm Animal before.
I was thinking, okay, we're gonna be outside. I'll take, just so everybody knows the spells, because I find them to be useful, I took Entangle, Calm Animal, since we're gonna be outside, and Thought Capture, since we're gonna try to solve a mystery.
All right, nice. Yeah, so what does
Calm Animal do? Other than, and quiet normal animals, which render them docile and harmless. Only creatures with intelligence of 1 to 4, in other words, animals or semi-intelligent creatures, can be affected by the spell. Can calm 2d4 hit dice of animals plus 1 hit die per level. So I can automatically do at least 3 levels, or 3 hit dice.
You can automatically do 3 hit dice?
Yeah, because it's 2d4 plus 1 per level.
2d4 plus 1 per level is 3, yeah, all right. Okay. So this thing walks up to you, because it goes next, mm-hmm. and it becomes less menacing as it does, and begins licking your face.
Oh, dude, that's so cute. Wow.
That's okay. I would taste me before I ate me too.
it takes its paw and just kind of wraps around you and begins like grooming you.
I'm still in the middle of spell casting, so I probably have my eyes closed and I'm chanting something weird. Let me know when my initiative comes up.
You are on initiative 11. You go after Fuzzy. Dave Grau.
Well, I was going to shoot it, but seeing as how he's just like, you know, it's now licking the kobold, I'm just going to be like, aw, dude, that's so cute, man.
All right. Okay, all of the 11s go.
I'm going to do, I'm going to use my ventriloquism to try and throw my voice next to the Wolverine and just be like, I love you, you're my friend.
Oh my god, I wish I had animal friendship. Can you imagine if I had a pet Wolverine?
Well, sorry?
I said I wish I had animal friendship. Somebody in chat mentioned pet. I was like, oh god, I should have taken animal friendship. I'd like a pet Wolverine that would be like 10 times more powerful than me.
Greg, what did you say about ventriloquism?
I was going to ask Rob if he believed in the ventriloquism.
All right.
We needed to roll for it.
Do you want me to roll for it, yeah?
It's up to his character.
You speak common.
I think that's a no need to roll.
Okay, sounds good. So 11, all of you are going at once. So Luther, Alejandro, and Artie, all of your actions occur simultaneously.
I pass my spell, fail check, and I cast Sunscorch at the Wolverine.
That's currently hugging.
Does Sunscorch have any area effect at all? What does Sunscorch say?
This spell creates a brilliant ray of scorching heat that slants down from the sky to strike one target of the caster's choice. The victim is entitled to a saving throw versus spell to avoid the damage.
All right. I'm not gonna make our kobold roll for it. But as soon as that dice roll comes through, nope, it fails its save.
He takes 7 points of damage as scorching heat blisters away the leaves and ravages the Wolverine's body.
All right. That scorching heat comes down and strikes it. And you hear it scream and bark and get very angry and upset. Yeah. And although it looks hurt, it's now a wounded animal and it's very, very angry.
So I'm gonna... I guess I did like fist... I rolled
fist. The Wolverine, what? Sorry.
Yeah, like, so I think that as like he's doing that, like, and we're... I think Alejandro might actually believe that the Wolverine is actually going to like, just tasting him. Like literally tasting him before he's eating him. Because I have 5 int as well. It's like, get off
you. You have 5 hands?
Yeah, I have 5 hands. No, 5 intelligence.
Oh, I heard you had 5 hands, and I was like, "What are you playing?"
He's playing a yoga instructor.
But that's what it feels like when I fist you.
Okay, well, start fisting the Wolverine, I guess.
I have two weapon fighting. Two weapon fighting style. So I get two attacks, I think.
You can go ahead and take like a plus two to your roll for like getting, you can move around it, get a flank or a backstab on it. Like not a true backstab, but a backstab.
Well, 19.
All right, that's one hit.
I roll damage.
Plus seven.
The oily man is fisting the Wolverine.
I have plus five. I have 18 strength.
Niarb knows that very well.
So it's seven damage with the first fist. And
all right, and with one mighty fisting, the Wolverine like pops, and its guts run all over your hand, and it lies dead and bloodied in front of you.
Dude, what the hell?
Are you okay, Niarb?
What the hell?
I was until it exploded.
What the?
It tried to eat you.
Good job, Alejandro. You've done a very good.
Dude, oh, no, good. You, short and fucking spellcasty. Yo, no, man. You that thing was perfectly calm and you just...
I saved the day! How could you say anything
other
than...
It was chill, man. It was chill. It was licking his face. It was calm, man. God, you need
I
to,
thought
like,
it was going to eat him.
What was that?
No, it's okay. Niarb doesn't expect any of his friends to stick around.
Oh, man.
I kneel down. I am so sorry.
I'm not.
No, it's the way of the world. God say, fuck kobolds.
Luther, what do you think of this?
Well, what's done is done.
Do you think this was a miss?
I think it's better dead than leaving it alive and taking a chance. Let's just carry on. All of this arguing over nothing. One dead creature.
But it was just... Oh, man. Whatever. You guys.
I'm sure its place in the ecosystem is totally unnecessary.
Yeah, very, very. Just running his own business, man. Anyway, yeah, let's get on. We've got a dead guy in a hole to find. There.
Yeah, like in the ARP, you got something on your face.
All right, the six of you pack up after a quick encounter and continue heading onwards. And the rest of your 4-hour journey goes along no issues, despite a popped Wolverine behind you. And you crest a clearing, and you see a very poor farming village that's kind of logged inside of the forest here. And there's you can hear running water, but it's not seen here. So it's nearby to a river, but not necessarily on the town. All of the cottages are fairly plain in make. They're wood with kind of thatched roofing. There's not a lot of fanciness or high quality make here. One in particular probably stands out to you because it has a leaning hawthorn tree and a big lilac bush in front of it, just as the story was said. And the smaller cottage lies a few hundred yards next to that one. Kind of in the center of the village, there is two larger buildings. There's one that without a thatched roof, this one has like slats that are on it, and it's a two-story. It's the only two-story building here, shaped very much kind of the way a traditional temple is, with a kind of peaked roof. Gregor turns around and looks at you all and says, this is the town hall. And then he points next to it, and there's a single floor building right next to it in the center of town, only identifiable from the other ones by a dilapidated sign that hangs at a jaunty angle. And it has just the picture of a full mug that's faded into the wood. He says, that's where we meet after the work is done. My brother will probably be there once the fields are sown and whatnot. And as you look over, you can kind of see these cottages are all kind of centrally facing the big one. And then behind them, there are fields with various grains and whatever being worked. And there are wooden fences around pastures for like sheep and goats and a couple cows.
Are you married? Do you have a wife?
Gregor shakes his head, says, no, women never liked me that much. They always fell for my brother instead.
You got some serious, like, you need to believe in yourself more. Well, you needed to believe in yourself, and then, dude, you murdered your brother, and, you know, pretty much screwed it, aren't you?
That's probably
the only way this could be more fucked up is if it turned out that he never had a brother at all.
Oh, dude, that would be a fucking trip, man.
I quite assure you that that it was my brother. It is indeed mine. I would.
And what's his name?
What's your name? You didn't tell us your name.
Have you looked in a mirror
Gregory
recently?
And Nicholas.
My name is Gregor. Nicholas.
Oh, right. Gregor and Nicholas.
My brother.
So Gregor, why don't you take us to where you killed Nicholas?
You murderer.
I don't want to go back there. I'm quite deathly afraid of the woods.
Yeah, dude.
I think you'll be safe with us.
And man, if you want us to solve your problem, then dude, really, you really gotta like.
Right now.
Yes, now. Yeah, let's go there first.
Come on, we're doing it, man. What's the worst that could happen? Your zombie brother could turn up and try and face you. You know, bite your you know. Well, actually, you know, your zombie brother's already, you know, banging his wife. Maybe I don't know, man.
Is the worst
was
banging married? His wife. If he had any.
Ew, what do you think would happen if, like, bits dropped off? No, never mind. Anyway.
That's disgusting, Dave. You should learn how to behave.
She could keep it for when he's not around.
Yeah, that's true, man.
If we find a body or not, we'll be able to eliminate certain things that this could be. If the body's gone, then perhaps it's undead. If the body's still there, then perhaps it's some sort of shapeshifter.
Is that another dick joke? Are you that sort of bloke?
I am not. Perhaps to you it's a joke.
I don't know, man. Sometimes I look at mine and I'm just like, laugh and I laugh, man.
That sounds unfortunate.
Hey, man.
All right.
People laugh when they look at me, Arps.
Hey, Arp, why are you showing people your penis?
They just laugh anyway.
I don't. It's when they gang up on me in the showers during school. It wasn't good.
You went to school?
Cobalt showers?
Cobalt school?
Yeah, cobalt school.
By shower, dude, do you mean just like that droopy bit of cave? Slightly more damp than the rest of the cave.
By shower, I mean they spit on me a lot.
Ew. Ew. Gross.
Wow.
You are pathetic.
Mm-hmm.
That's uncool, man.
I say it, right. I see it.
So, you convince him fairly easily to try to lead you out into the woods. In order to do so, he leads you through town and back up. And the lot of you get very suspicious looks from everyone as you walk past town. The wives sitting in town are staring at you, pointing at the kobold, eyeing the gnome suspiciously. Very
I'm probably
the brother's company.
I'm probably and, like, he leads you past the ladies a bit. Hey. Hi.
Give me a charisma check.
Okay. Charisma is 15. So that's D20 plus 15.
Yes, ma'am.
More charismatic than I am.
Oh yeah!
Oh yeah! Your finger guns and winking does a good job on a couple of the ladies. They blush a little red and they kind of give you a little side eye. One of them blows you a kiss as you walk by, but their looks, as much as they like you, turn to suspicion once again as they catch eye of Niarb.
Hot guy with a kobold. It's all good.
And you guys get led past the fields, much the same thing with the men, but no one stops you as they can definitely see Gregor is with you. And as we head off into the woods in search of this deep, dark hole, let's go ahead and take our break here. I think we're close to break time as it is.
We'll see you guys on the other side of our break. Bye-bye.